Hi there, I'm going to show you in this little video how to replace the Suzuki welded reeds. Most harmonicas come with reeds that are riveted on, but Suzuki is unique in welding their reeds on. And various reasons. I mean, it just gives a very, very precise alignment of the reed in the slot. I guess also for Suzuki it's just a more consistent and probably a cheaper manufacturing technique, I imagine. But anyway, for quite a few years now they've been using the welding process. So the question arises, you know, if a reed fails on a Suzuki harp, how do you replace the reed? And this is a question asked a lot of me, so I thought I'd make this short video all about it. Okay, well, the first thing you want to do is remove the old reed. Now, you can probably see this reed here is broken. It's sitting up a long way off the plate. And I've got a little reed wrench here. This is a Suzuki one. You could also make your own one out of anything you like. Here's one made out of a ruler. You can see the little thing that I've put in there. So all you do is basically just move the reed sideways like that, and off it comes. Okay, so now you need to find the right reed from another harmonica. Now the way to do that is to measure the slot using some calipers, and then just find another reed of roughly the same pitch. Can be within, you know, a tone either way, really. But if you can find exactly the same pitch, that's great. This is a D reed that I'm fixing, and this is going to be. I've selected this already, but you can see that that's the wrong length. That's the wrong length. So this is right. It's a D reed, and it's the right length. So again, I just wrench the reed off, and now I have my good reed. Okay, once you've got your reed and reed plate separated and got the new reed, tear off a little bit of masking tape. Get the reed the right way up and put it into the slot all the way in, and then put the masking tape over the reed like that. Just double check that everything's okay. And you can see the reed is just taped in place with the masking tape. Okay, now that the reed's taped in place, take it over to your workbench and put a 1.1 millimeter drill bit in your drill. I don't know what that is in imperial measures, but basically it's 1 millimeter. Start the drill. Now it's important to just drill right through the reed and the reed plate in one hit. Okay, turn the drill off and then remove the tape, and the reed will come away with it. Next thing to do is to tape that down on your piece of wood, and then I'm going to replace this 1 millimeter bit, 1.1 millimeter, sorry, with a 1.4 millimeter. Now this is important because of the size of the bolts that I'm going to be using to attach the reed with. Okay, so now we get we want to leave the 1.1 millimeter hole in the reed plate, and we want to put a 1.4 millimeter hole in the base of the reed. Cool, so that's all done, and now we move back to the workbench to fix the reed. Okay, now that you've got the two holes drilled, one in the reed plate and the other in your reed, just carefully
remove the tape, the reed from the tape. Get rid of that now. And now it's important to just clean up the base, the surfaces under the holes. So again, I use my little grinder. As I say, you could use a little file, perfectly fine, just to, you know, do the same kind of thing. Now on this, in the hole in the reed plate, what I'm going to do is just prepare the way for the screw by just reaming it out very slightly. Okay, so the next thing to do is to fix the reed onto the reed plate. And I just use the Suzuki reed bolts. They're tiny little things. I don't know if you can see that. It's just a little self-tapping screw. Just fix the end onto your screwdriver. So the thing is just to basically get the reed, put it into the slot, and make sure the holes are lined up. And then you get your self-tapping screw and you apply a little bit of pressure so it taps its way into the brass. Now, before it's finally tightened up, just hold it up against the light. You can't see me doing that, but I'm just holding up the reed plate and looking around the reed to see that it's all lined up. There's a little bit of leeway around this hole, the 1.4 millimeter hole. And now I'm just tightening up, and again just checking the light around the reed. So you should be able to see light, a sliver of light all the way around the reed. And when you press the reed in, it should just come away without hitting the sides. So now if I try that reed, it's sounding good. Okay, the final thing then is to tune the reed up to the correct pitch. For that I just use a little chromatic tuner. Now I want a D note here, so I'll just check this. It's actually very good. I was using a D reed and the reed's in tune, so slightly sharp maybe, but I'll wait till I assemble the harmonica to do the final gapping and other processes. Okay, that's the whole process completed. I hope you can see from this video that replacing the Suzuki welded reeds is not a daunting prospect, and it doesn't take any fancy skills or fancy tools. I've just been using basic tools that most people would have in their workshop. A small drill press, a couple of drills, a reed wrench, a file, a screwdriver, and that's about it really. A small polishing wheel if you prefer to the file. And the whole process normally takes me about 5 minutes, which is not that dissimilar to replacing the riveted reeds on a Hohner harmonica or whatever. The most time consuming thing is finding the correct reed from your old harmonicas, and you can streamline that a wee bit by when your old harps get superseded, just remove the reed plates, mark them with keys, and put them in a box somewhere, and then it's not hard to find the right reed. So here's the reed I replaced. Sounds pretty good. Let's hear what it sounds like on a harmonica comb. It's a Bluesmaster reed plate. I'm just popping the plates onto the comb, and here's the reed. Okay, sounds pretty good. Hope you've enjoyed watching this video and learned something from it. If you've got any queries, just put some comments in the YouTube comment box, and I'll get back to you. Thanks a lot. Bye.